You know, coincidence can be terrible. These robberies all bear your mark. What I can't understand is how this thief could imitate me so perfectly. Goes up walls, over the roofs, down through the skylights. Leaves no clue, and then disappears in the night.
Now John Robbie, the cat.
You don't believe me any more than you.
So?
Well, he just kept on going. He said the good thing about being a pessimist is when things don't go as you expect them to, you're not surprised and are more accepting of your situation. I said, are you a pessimist or an optimist? He said, well, what do you think? I said, having just given an optimistic view of pessimism, I thought he was half full of shit. He said, oh, you're an optimist. I said, why? He said, half full of shit. He didn't get my little dig. I said, no, half empty in this case would be optimistic, as being totally full of shit was not an optimistic characteristic. He called me pessimistic. I said, why? He said, I didn't quite see the positive side of being totally full of shit. I said, is there one? He said, yeah. When people start not believing a single word you're saying, it's not surprising when they start not trusting you. I told him I did not believe a single word he was saying. He called me a cynic, so I hit him.
You haven't answered my question.
A cynic? You believe that? He kept saying he and I were alike. I told him he was delusional, kidding himself. I told him we were poles apart. I quite like that.
What?
The positive-negative thing, playing on words. Damn cheek. One of those, what star sign are you geeks? I can't stand that.
Star sign?
Yeah, the date on which you were born seems incredibly important in judging what kind of character you are before getting to know you, therefore allowing themselves without prejudice to decide on whether you're worth getting to know or not, so the case may be.
Well, that is prejudiced.
Of course it fucking is. That is my point. He kept banging on about human rights and whatnot.
Human rights.
Yeah. Everyone has a right to food, shelter, free speech, etc. Jesus, the list was endless. The more he spoke, the more he just pissed me off. He went on about squatters' rights.
Squatters' rights?
Yeah, you know. Under the old everyone has a right to shelter banner. I told him squatters have no rights.
They don't?
Well, Christ, you know? Every situation has a cause and effect, man. I mean, you do what you have to do, right? But I just couldn't help it. He kind of brought it out in me. I tell you, saying that really set the cat amongst the chickens.
Pigeons.
What?
Never mind. Look, listen.
Jesus, but it got him going. Capitalism is the root of all evil. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Property is theft, etc. I said, if property is theft, how is possession 9/10 of the law? He hated that. He's such a fucking hippie. He said, this land is your land, this land is my land. Doesn't that mean anything to me? I said, I hated Bob Dylan. He said, who the fuck is Bob Dylan? I couldn't believe my fucking ears. I was caught. I tell you, I was caught in an irritating web of circular chit-chat. I was ready to put my cigarette out in his eye.
So you smoke?
No. Yeah.
You either smoke or you don't. Which is it?
I did. But I still use that phrase, though.
Why?
I don't smoke anymore, but I still feel like putting my stub out in some dummy's eye, even though I don't... Anyway, you know, this is beside the point. He was talking, but he wasn't saying anything.
Sounds familiar.
He kept reciting endless phrases that he thought sounded cool. I don't know about you, but I find that senseless, mimicky, parrot-like recitation positively irritating.
So an optimistic view of a negative trait.
What?
Positively irritating.
That's what I said.
That's what you said before.
Nothing's changed?
Everything's changed.
You're not listening to me.
That's all I've been doing.
So I said to him, where do you live?
Mother,
he said, what's
fucker.
That got to do with anything? I said, where someone lives says a lot about their personality. He laughed and told me I was bullshitting. Of course I was. I said, are you a homeowner or a rentee? Neither, he said, starting to get a bit cagey. So you're squatting, I said. Maybe, he said, great, I said, I'll stay at your place. That worried him, of course it did. I'll stay at your place and that'll be just dandy. You got any food? You should have seen his face. He started umming and ahhing and getting a bit sweaty with all these feeble excuses. Christ, I don't really need to ask, do I? Is your land, is my land, etc. But you ain't Bob Dylan, he says. Well, I didn't make the fucking rules, man. You fucking did! Well, he says, well, you just can't invite yourself onto someone's property like that. But property is theft, is it not? I said. Jesus Christ. Yeah, I guess, he said hesitantly. His argument had more holes in it than a teabag.
Okay.
So I said to him, I'll stay in your room and you can keep on the sofa. Man, he really thought I wanted to stay in his flea-ridden fucking home. I tell you, if it wasn't for the fact that I wanted...
Enough!
Jesus. Calm down, man. What is it?
What the hell are you doing in my house?
This land is your land, and this land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me.